If you have an old version of Extreme PBR added into your blender, you need to uninstall it. Go to Edit. Press Preferences. From Add-ins, search for Extreme PBR. And press Remove. Now restart Blender. If you are a Macintosh user and are using Safari, be aware that Safari automatically decompresses .zip files. So take 1 minute more time and use Mozilla Firefox or Google Chrome to download your zip files. Once you have purchased Extreme PBR from Gumroad or Blender Market, download the add-in from order page. The add-in is the file with the name Extreme PBR V4. Versions may have a different number, the file is in zip format. Download the zip file to a folder of your choice. Now download the files with the XAPIC format. These are the libraries. My advice is to start by downloading Procedural Library Volume 1, 05K Library Volume 1, and 1000 Library Volume 1. In this way, you can already start installing and using Extreme PBR. Now, open Blender. Go to Edit. Preferences. Make sure you are on the tab Add-ins. Press the Install button. Look for the add-in zip file, extreme_pbr_v4. Select zip file. Now, press Install Add-in. If all goes well, the add-in is now listed. You can also search for it by entering Extreme PBR. We activate the add-in. The add-in is displayed in the 3D view interface in the Extreme PBR tab of the sidebar. Now let's install the libraries. Press Default Library button. Choose the path of where you want to install the libraries. Make sure it's a location where you have space available. The libraries up to 8000 take up more than 180 gigabytes. If you have never used Extreme PBR, do not enter the path for the user library. It will be created automatically next to the main library. Now press the Choose XAPIX button. Select the path where you downloaded the XAPIX files. You will be able to select which libraries you want to install. You can even select them all if you want. Confirm. Now, the list of XAPIX files you selected is available in the list. If you want to keep XAPIX packages on your computer, check Keep XAPIX after install. I advise against doing this. This takes up double the disk space. Now, we press Install from XAPIX files to start the library installation process. The execution time of the installation of the libraries depends a lot on the type of hard disk in use. The process on an SSD is much faster, while on a mechanical hard disk it is much slower. If you want to continue working with Blender, I recommend opening another instance of Blender. Don't close the preferences interface, minimize it, otherwise the process stops. As soon as the first package is 100% installed, the add-in interface will be activated. Once the library installation process is finished, press the Confirm button. If you have not set up automatic save preferences, press Save Preferences. Now the libraries are installed. If you don't see them all, set the library back to Extreme PBR Library or restart Blender. If you want to check what you have installed and what is available to download, just go to the Updates menu. Thank you. In the left column, you have the list of volumes available online. Those marked in green are those installed. In the right column, you will only see what you have installed. This lets you always know what is installed and what is not. Remember that libraries must be linked in the add-in to see this. Thanks for watching.